tell me your name?
Maggie.
Maggie. Okay, Maggie. Is there anybody I can call and come get you? Maggie.
Maggie.
Come on, you need to cooperate or you're gonna go with the cops. So tell me who I can call and come get you.
I'm going home.
So, it's official that I can have my bonfire party on the beach for my birthday.
You can have your bonfire party at the beach, but it can't last past 9 o'clock, and your grandmother and I'll both be there.
No! Just be at the beach. You cannot be standing there with us.
I'm not gonna leave a bunch of teenagers alone in the dark.
Dad will let us do it.
Well, Dad is not here, okay?
Why do you always have to be like this? Why can't you just be a little bit understanding?
Why can't you, Katie? None of this is easy.
Mama.
I want to tell you a story about a guy who's down and out. He's literally face down in the gutter, going nowhere. This is a guy who had everything in life, and then he's gotten to the point where he didn't even care about life. And it's 2 a.m., and he's in the middle of the city, and he's literally face down drunk, lying there. Someone starts rifling through his wallet. He doesn't care, he just figures he's being mugged and it doesn't matter to him. Car pulls up next to him and he's picked up and dragged and he's thrown in the back seat of the car and he's driven away. Car travels for a few miles and it stops and he's pulled from out of the car and he's dragged and then he's just dumped. He looks up at the last second and sees a taxi cab driving away. And then he looks down and he realizes he's on the front porch of his house. And you know, this story, it resonates with me because it's my story. And I spent the night on that porch. And I woke up that next morning and I asked myself, how did I get here? I mean, had I really fallen this far? And the reality was, is that I had become the prodigal son.
I was running from God, just like the son was running from the father. And every prodigal must feel like, how did I get here? Or how did I fall this far? You see, I was looking for excitement. I was looking for something enticing. And what happened was, I landed in this land of disappointment, and it was a hard place. I remember lying on that porch thinking, I just want to go home. I just want to be with my family. And there's a great part about that because I never worried about whether my parents loved me. I never worried about whether my family would welcome me home. But there's a part of me that doesn't feel the same way about God, because sometimes I think he's going to punish me, or I think he wants to teach me a lesson. And what happens is I hide from him. I stay away, because it feels safer that way. And I don't know if I feel this because it's just, I'm worried about his displeasure with me, or it's just my distaste for myself. But somewhere within my mind, there's a part of me that feels like God can be very uninviting. That's not how God is. He's a mirror image of what I have in my mind. You see, it's not a gesture from afar. It's not a wave from the distance. See, the Father, he is at a full out sprint. He is saying, welcome home. He's saying, I'm glad you're here. the father. Doesn't give a lecture. He doesn't discipline him. What he does is he throws the son a party. There's a reality in my life. I'm the prodigal son every day. I run from God and I hide from him. And maybe in one way or another, you are too. Maybe you've been hiding from God. Maybe it's been years or months or maybe just a few moments. It's time to head home. Make your way back. Chances are you'll be met by the Father even before you get there.
I was just sitting there. And I won't lie, I wished I'd have been the one to die instead of him. But then I heard a voice as clear as day. Make this the last time, Maggie. So I came here.
Maggie, you say every time is the last time.
Sarah, please.
No, Mom. How many times do we have to hear this? Who cuts me a break?
Sarah, I don't expect you to forgive me.
You shouldn't have to.
I don't believe this. Can't you see that she's using you? But you keep sending her back out there to fail.
When I was 18, I was sure I was in love. I mean, this guy was as perfect as he could be. A real James Dean. He told me he loved me and we were gonna be together forever. Except my parents didn't see it that way. So I ran away from home and I married him. 2 months later, I was pregnant and he was gone. When I went to my parents' house, my dad shut the door in my face. And then I met your father. And he loved me just the way I was. And he loved you too, Sarah. Just like you were his own. Maggie's my daughter. In the same way that I love you, I love her. I will not close the door on her.
Katie is very impressionable. If you're gonna stay in this house, you need to know that what you say and what you do can have a huge impact on her.
I know.
Welcome home, then.